If a single Tornado-S strike can erase an entire ammunition depot deep behind Ukrainian lines before a single alarm is sounded, then what happens when dozens of them are unleashed simultaneously across NATO-supplied bases? What if tomorrow it's not just Dnipro that burns, but every logistics hub, every radar station, every airstrip from Lviv to the Polish border? Will the West still feel safe behind its illusions of defense, or will it be too late to scream? In the blackened silence before dawn, somewhere deep behind Ukrainian lines, the earth trembles. A distant thunder grows louder, not from the sky, but from the ground, 20-ton beasts stirring awake. Engines growl, systems prime, coordinates lock in. Then, without warning, the Russian Tornado-S speaks. The Tornado-S is not just a weapon, it is a predator, a modern mechanized reaper that stalks its prey from over 100 kilometers away. When it strikes, nothing is left but molten steel, shattered concrete, and echoes of panic. This is the face of next-generation warfare, engineered chaos, delivered with surgical accuracy. And in June 2025, its wrath was once again unleashed. This time, on a critical Ukrainian ammunition depot near Dnipro, a site thought to be untouchable, a site that is now, quite literally, a crater in the earth. To understand how such destruction is possible, we need to go back. Born from the ashes of the Soviet BM-30 Smerch, the Tornado-S is Russia's most advanced multiple-launch rocket system. First fielded in the early 2010s, it was a technological leap forward, a self-propelled artillery platform designed not to saturate, but to obliterate. It can launch 12 300-millimeter guided rockets in under a minute, each one more intelligent and more lethal than anything that came before. The Tornado-S uses precision-guided munitions such as the 9M544 and 9M549, smart rockets that communicate with satellites mid-flight, adjusting their trajectory in real time. This isn't just a rocket barrage, it's a coordinated strike, each warhead programmed for a different target, a different altitude, a different detonation method. On June 27, 2025, at approximately 2:43 a.m., a salvo was launched from somewhere in Zaporizhia Oblast. The rocket screamed across the night sky at Mach speeds, invisible to radar, undetectable by air defenses. Within minutes, Ukrainian radar stations in Dnipro picked up the blast, not the launch. The impact. 12 guided warheads struck the ammunition depot in sequence, not simultaneously, intentionally staggered. The first strike penetrated the roof. The second targeted reinforced walls. The third ignited fuel storage. And the rest? They finished the job. What followed was a chain reaction of explosions that lit up the skyline like a nuclear dawn. Secondary blasts continued for nearly 40 minutes as stored munitions cooked off under the rising inferno. Nothing survived. But how could Ukraine, equipped with Western air defense systems, fail to stop this? The answer lies in the Tornado-S's stealth by design. These rockets fly low, beneath radar arcs. Their guidance systems, using the Russian GLONASS satellite network, combined with inertial navigation, do not emit active signals. They're silent killers. Even if detected, they arrive too fast, too close, and too many at once. Systems like NASAMS or Patriot are designed for aircraft or ballistic threats, not a coordinated swarm of semi-ballistic rockets emerging from the fog of war. And unlike cruise missiles, Tornado-S rockets are cheap, quick to deploy, and mobile. A KAMAZ 8x8 truck can reposition within minutes of a launch. It's a textbook shoot and scoot. Fire, Relocate, vanish. But perhaps what makes the Tornado-S most dangerous is not just its hardware, but the intelligence behind it. The June 27 strike wasn't blind, it was calculated. Russian reconnaissance drones, likely Orlan 10s or Zela, had been circling the area for days. Electronic eavesdropping, satellite images, and even local human assets may have helped confirm the exact location and layout of the depot. Once confirmed, the fire mission was uploaded, and the Tornado-S units positioned under cover of darkness. The entire kill chain, from identification to destruction, took less than 48 hours. This is modern war, where distance no longer protects you, where even silence does not mean safety. The warhead variants themselves are brutal in design. Some detonate in midair, raining down thousands of high-velocity fragments. Others penetrate deep before erupting in a firestorm of heat and shockwaves. And still others scatter submunitions, cluster bombs that continue killing minutes, hours, even days after impact. Reports from the Dnipro strike indicate that unexploded bomblets were found as far as 300 meters from the impact site. EOD teams worked frantically through the day to neutralize them, but the damage had been done. Ammunition stores worth tens of millions reduced to ash, Ukrainian troop morale shaken, and strategic reserves cut off. The Tornado-S is not just a weapon, it is a message, a psychological operation in itself. Its silence before impact, the suddenness of its strike, the precision of its destruction, all calculated to instill fear, uncertainty, and paralysis. It tells Ukraine, nowhere is safe. And it tells the world, the rules of engagement have changed. Where once artillery was dumb, area-based, and easily dodged, today's systems are algorithmic, coordinated, and unrelenting. The Tornado-S proves that large-scale destruction no longer requires missiles costing millions. All it takes is intelligence, mobility, and ruthless intent. As the fires from Dnipro fade into smoke, the Tornado-S disappears once again, back into the forests, the plains, the ghostly night, ready to strike again, ready to remind the world that in this war, the sky doesn't just rain missiles, it rains vengeance.